ब्रॉट टू यू बाय गीतांजलि सैलून छन्नी हिम्मत जम्मू फॉलो रुचिका मेकओवर्स ऑन फेसबुक एंड इंस्टाग्राम फॉर बेस्ट ब्राइडल मेकअप इन टाउन।
हेलो व्यूअर्स, यू आर वॉचिंग जम्मू लिंक्स न्यूज। आई एम मन्नत गुप्ता एंड वेलकम टू द डेली अपडेट्स ऑफ मिड डे न्यूज। लेट्स बिगिन।
Three unidentified militants were killed in an encounter with the security forces in Jammu and Kashmir's Anantnag district on Monday. The security forces launched a cordon and search operation at Khulchohar in the South Kashmir district following information about the presence of terrorists in the area. The operation turned into an encounter after the terrorist fired upon a search party of the forces, who retaliated. The identity and group affiliation were being ascertained. Girls outshined boys in J&K Board of School Education results for class 12th in UT Summer Zone, Jammu on Sunday, with both government and private schools showing a marked improvement despite a challenging situation due to COVID-19 outbreak. A total of 33,779 students, 17,759 boys and 16,020 girls were enrolled for the examination, out of which 26,139 have passed. The pass percentage for girls was recorded at 82%, while it was 73% for boys. Prime Minister Narendra Modi asserted on Sunday that India has given a befitting reply to those who cast an evil eye on its territory in Ladakh, stating that while the country honours the spirit of friendship, it is also capable of giving an appropriate response to any adversary. Paying tributes to the 20 army men martyred in the violent standoff with China's People's Liberation Army, earlier this month, PM Modi also said that India's brave soldiers have shown that they will not allow the nation's pride to be hurt. India recorded 19,459 new coronavirus cases and 380 deaths in the last 24 hours, according to the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare on Monday. The total coronavirus cases in the country stands at 5,48,318, including 2,10,120 active cases, 3,21,723 cured or discharged or migrated, and 16,475 deaths. Former Chief Minister and National Conference President Dr. Farooq Abdullah has said that he wants unity among various political parties in Jammu and Kashmir to fight against rights that were snatched illegally and unconstitutionally from the people. Speaking to reporters on the sidelines of a condolence meeting in Anantnag on Sunday, Dr. Abdullah said that they were against everything which is illegal.
The government has started.
We are saying we are united against everything that they have done. Which is illegal, which is unconstitutional. How do you think I'm going to accept what is unconstitutional?
So, any reaction on India-China's face-off?
India-China or India-Pakistan? The only future is talk. War is not a solution.
The Jammu and Kashmir police has arrested the mother of a slain terrorist and the sister of an active militant in Kulgam district for their alleged involvement in terrorist recruitment. Inspector General of Police Kashmir Vijay Kumar said the mother of killed terrorist Tausif Naseema Banu was involved in recruiting youths into terrorist ranks. The Jammu and Kashmir police has rejected the criticism that it was targeting family members of the militants without evidence. President of District Congress Committee Riyasi and former Minister Jugal Kishore Sharma has demanded opening of all temple and shrines like Mata Vaishno Devi Shrine, Shiv Khori Shrine, Machel Mata Temple and other religious places across Jammu and Kashmir, maintaining that these shrines are not only places of worship but also the only source of livelihood for many families. He added that there are numerous shrines in the region which cater to multiple families and local vendors as the only way of economic survival.
आपका रघुनाथ मंदिर है जम्मू में, या बूढ़े अमरनाथ जी का मंदिर है, मचेल माता जी का मंदिर है, ये सारी संस्थाएं, ये सारे मंदिर वगैरह सोशल डिस्टेंस से जो भी आप गाइडलाइन बनाते हैं, जैसे आपने बाकी बनाई थी, आप उसमें सैनिटाइजेशन कर सकते हैं, आप टनल जो इसके सैनिटाइज के हैं ये आप लगा सकते हैं। इन चीज़ों को खोलने से और लोगों को अगर मौका मिलेगा जिस वक्त वो जाएंगे, चाहे वो यात्रा कम हो ज़्यादा हो, आए कम आए, उसमें आप फिगर फिक्स कर सकते हैं, उसमें आप कंट्रोल कर सकते हैं।
A government order asking oil marketing companies to stock up 2 months' supply of LPG cylinders in Kashmir Valley has sparked speculations, especially in the wake of the LAC face-off, with NC leader Omar Abdullah questioning the need for such a move. According to the June 27th order issued by the Director of the Food, Civil Supplies and Consumer Affairs Department in Kashmir, an advisor to Jammu and Kashmir, Lieutenant Governor G.C. Murmu, has passed directions in a meeting on June 23rd to ensure sufficient stocks of LPG in the valley as the supply of the same gets affected due to closure of the national highway on account of frequent landslides. Doda has become totally terrorist-free district after Hizbul Mujahideen commander Masood was neutralized in an encounter, Jammu and Kashmir Director General of Police Dilbagh Singh said. 3 terrorists including Masood were killed in an encounter with security forces at Khul Chohar area of Anantnag. The J&K DGP said that Masood, who hails from Doda district, was involved in a rape case registered by Doda police and was absconding ever since. Home Minister Amit Shah said on Sunday that India will win the battle against coronavirus, which has originated from the Chinese city of Wuhan, as well as the border standoff in Ladakh with China, which escalated on June 15th. Speaking to a news agency in an interview, Amit Shah said that he wants to assure the Indians that the country will win both the battles under PM Modi's leadership.
इनके नेता के हैशटैग को पाकिस्तान और चीन बढ़ावा दे रहा है। आप ऐसी बात करते हो जो पाकिस्तान और चीन पसंद करता है। और ऐसे संकट के समय में पार्लियामेंट होनी है, चर्चा करनी है तो आइए करेंगे। 62 से लेकर आज तक दो-दो हाथ हो जाए, कोई नहीं डरता चर्चा से।
The leaders of the National Conference and the Congress feel threatened due to the new domicile rules in Jammu and Kashmir as they had for long thrived on their captive vote bank, Union Minister Dr. Jitendra Singh said on Sunday. He alleged that the people of Jammu and Kashmir suffered because of such politicians who have over the last several decades hoodwinked their own people in order to promote their dynastic rule from generation to generation. The total number of COVID-19 cases in Jammu and Kashmir crossed the 7,000 mark on Sunday as 127 more people tested positive for the disease. 25 of these new cases were reported from the Jammu region and 102 from the valley. 4 districts, Samba, Rajouri, Riasi and Kishtwara, had no fresh cases. So far, 94 COVID-19 patients have died in the Union Territory. For the first time in its history, the annual fair of Baba Sidh Gauriya was not held at Baba Sidh Gauriya's Sankar Temple in District Samba on Sunday due to spread of COVID-19 and advisories issued by the government of maintaining social distance. As the precedents, lakhs of devotees drawn from Jammu region and neighbouring states of Punjab, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh and even Delhi and UP used to visit the holy shrine to participate in the celebrations, which were held with full religious fervour and gaiety every year. However, the management committee of the shrine and some local devotees performed puja and held aarti at holy shrine, but the usual rush was missing and the shrine wore a deserted look. The first indoor-cum-outdoor sports stadium is all set to open in Rajouri's Peer Panjal region. The construction of the stadium initiated under Khelo India program was delayed due to the COVID-19 pandemic. However, after almost 2.5 months, the work has resumed and is in its final stage.